We're asked to determine the value of each expression. Here we have three exponential expressions. So for A, we have 2 to the fourth power, or 2 to the fourth, where the base is 2 and the exponent is 4. Exponential notation is a way to write repeated multiplication. So here, because the exponent is 4, we have 4 factors of 2. So 2 to the fourth is equal to 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. Again, the base is 2, so our factor is 2. And because the exponent is 4, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 factors of 2. So to find the value of 2 to the fourth, we need to find this product, multiplying from left to right. 2 times 2 is equal to 4. So now we have 4 times 2 times 2. Multiplying from left to right again, now we have 4 times 2, which equals 8. So we have 8 times 2. And 8 times 2 is equal to 16. So now we know the value of 2 to the fourth is 16. Next we have 4 to the second power times 4 to the third power, which we can also read as 4 squared times 4 cubed. So 4 to the second power, or 4 squared, means we have 2 factors of 4. So 4 times 4 times 4 to the third power, or 4 cubed, means we have 3 factors of 4. So times 4, times 4, times 4. Again, here's 4 squared, and here's 4 cubed. And now we multiply from left to right. 4 times 4 is equal to 16. So we have 16 times 4 times 4 times 4. Multiplying from left to right again, now we have 16 times 4, which equals 64. So we have 64 times 4 times 4. Of course, we can show work for 16 times 4 if we need to. 16 times 4. First, we have 4 times 6, which is 24. So we put a 4 in the ones place value. And now we perform an exchange for the 21s for 2 tens. And then 4 times 1 is 4 plus 2, which gives us 6 tens. And the product is 64, as we see here. Next, we have 64 times 4, which equals 256. So we have 256 times 4. Again, if we need to, we can show this work. 64 times 4. Well, first we have 4 times 4, which is 16. So we have a 6 in the ones place value, a 1 in the tens place value. 6 times 4 is 24 plus 1, which is 25, giving us the product of 256. And then finally, we have 256 times 4. So 4 times 6 is 24. We have a 2 in the tens place value. 4 times 5 is 20 plus 2, that's 22. So we have a 2 in the tens place value, a 2 in the hundreds place value, and then 4 times 2 is 8 plus 2 is 10, giving us a product of 1024. So now we know that 4 to the second power, or 4 squared, times 4 to the third power, or 4 cubed, equals 1024, or has a value of 1024. We'll come back to this exponential expression after we take a look at part C. For part C, we have 4 raised to the fifth power, or just 4 to the fifth. Because the exponent is 5, we have 5 factors of 4. So 4 to the fifth is equal to 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. Now if we take a look at 4 to the fifth and compare it to 4 to the second times 4 to the third, notice how in both cases we have 5 factors of 4, which means we should be able to recognize that the value of 4 to the fifth is the same as 4 to the second times 4 to the third, or 4 squared times 4 cubed. So we can save ourselves quite a bit of time by recognizing that 4 to the fifth power is also going to be 1024. And before we go though, I'd like to point out a couple more things. Let's go back and take a look at 4 to the second times 4 to the third again and find the value of this in a slightly different way. We're never wrong to expand exponential notation into repeated multiplication, but if we were to follow the order of operations strictly, we are supposed to simplify the exponents first before multiplying. So another way to find this value would be to first find the value of 4 squared, or 4 to the second, which is 4 times 4, which equals 16, and then also to find the value of 4 to the third, or 4 cubed, which is 4 times 4 times 4, which equals 64. So we could also determine the value of this product by determining the product of 16 and 64. Remember, we know we should get the value of 1024. Let's go and check this product to make sure we get the same value. So we have 16 times 64, which we can also write as 64 times 16. Let's find the product in this order. So 64 times 16, we would have 6 times 4, that's 24, so a 4 in the ones place value, a 2 in the tens place value. 6 times 6 is 36, plus 2 is 38. Now we're going to multiply by the 1, but this 1 is in the tens place value, so we'll put a 0 in the ones place value, and our first product is 1 times 4, which is 4. But again, the reason why we have a 0 here is that we really found the product of 10 times 4, giving us 40. And then we have 1 times 6, which is 6. So we have a 6 in the hundreds place value. And now we add. So we have 4. 8 plus 4 is 12. So we perform an exchange and have a 1 in the hundreds place value. 3 plus 6 is 9 plus 1 is 10, giving us the same value of 1024. But again, it's never wrong to expand exponential notation and write it as repeated multiplication. And there's one last connection I would like to make. Let's compare 4 to the 5th and 4 to the 2nd times 4 to the 3rd again. Again, we know in both cases we have 5 factors of 4. One property of exponents is that when multiplying and the bases are the same, when we multiply, the base stays the same and we add the exponents. Notice how, so if we wanted to find the product of 4 to the 2nd and 4 to the 3rd in exponential notation, we would multiply and then we would add the exponents. Notice how 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, meaning this product is equal to 4 to the 5th. So in general we say a to the m times a to the n is equal to a to the m plus n. This may look a little confusing, but what it's telling us is when we're multiplying and the bases are the same, we add the exponents. Meaning in our case, 4 to the 2nd power times 4 to the 3rd power is equal to 4 raised to the power of 2 plus 3, which is 4 to the 5th power, which we can see here do have the same value. I hope you found this helpful.